Welcome to second lecture on DAC fundamentals. DAC, so yesterday we were discussing about specifications of DAC. So we have written output voltage as a fraction of VREF, and further we have looked at full scale voltage of DAC, which is a maximum output voltage that can be generated and which can be represented as 2 to the power of n minus 1 by 2 to the power of n into VREF. And LSB is the smallest possible change which is possible at the output, or that is the smallest possible change in the analog output voltage. And whenever LSB changes by 1 bit, the change in LSB is your smallest possible change, and change in MSB accounts for a half, almost half of the VREF value will be changed. Now, even though LSB is the smallest possible change in the analog output voltage, we define one more specification for a DAC. We call it as resolution, where this resolution is expressed in the number of bits. So it is, that is also smallest change in the analog output with respect to VREF, but it is expressed in number of bits, and we have seen how the number of bits can be calculated for a given DAC if the minimum incremental voltage which is required is given. And I have given this simple example where you can actually write the input combinations as 2 to the power of 3, 2 to the power of 8, and 2 to the power of 16 with corresponding LSB values, percentage accuracy, and VFS. I hope you have calculated this. And if you have done this, you would have definitely got this relation between VFS, 1 LSB, and V reference. So your full scale voltage is V reference minus 1 LSB. Always, if we divide, if we express our output as F by 2 to the power of n, V by 2 to the power of n into VREF, if we express in this form, always your full scale voltage will be 1 LSB lesser than the reference voltage. Right? This is what we discussed yesterday. Now, let us start with this numerical. So, a question is, a digitally programmable signal generator uses a 14-bit DAC with a 10-volt reference. The reference voltage is 10 to generate DC output voltages for each input coming at the signal generator input. Now, the question is, what is the incremental change at the output that can occur? So, what is the incremental change at the output that can occur? And also, what is DAC's full-scale value? So, these are the two questions given. So, can you solve this? Given that DAC's number of bits, it is 14 bit DAC, so I can write n is 14 with a reference voltage. Reference is given as VREF is given as 10. So what is the incremental change at the output, and what is DAC's full scale value? So how to solve?
Find what is LSB.
So the incremental change at the output is nothing but LSB. So you can actually find what is 1 LSB value. How to write 1 LSB value?
1 by 2 power n.
It is not 1 by 2 power n, VREF by 2 power n.
VREF.
Yeah. So what is VREF here? VREF is 10 divided by 2 power n, where n is actually 14. So 2 power 14. Right. So what is your 1 LSB value? Yeah, to LSB value is Purushottam is telling it's 0.6 millivolt. Yes, it is 0.6 millivolt, or I can write it as 610 microvolts. Right. So this is 1 LSB value. Now, what is other question asked? So 1 LSB value is the incremental change at the output. Now, how to get DAC's full scale value? So DAC's full scale value is VFS. VFS can be written as VREF minus 1 LSB. which can be directly written from here. Right. What is full scale? 10 minus 610 microvolt, which is closely equal to 9.999 volts. So that is the full scale voltage of attack. So from your reference, if you subtract 1 LSB, you will get your you will get your full scale value, right? Okay. So can we move to next question? Yes. Can I try this? Attack has a full scale voltage. Again, it is 4.97 using a 5 volt reference. And its minimum output voltage is limited by value of 1 LSB. That is the smallest possible change at the output, 1 LSB value. Determine resolution and dynamic range. So we didn't define what is dynamic range. We'll see that. Anyway, you can find resolution. Resolution should be expressed in terms of number of bits. Right. So if I start writing these things, your full scale voltage is given as 4.97, your reference voltage is given as 5, minimum output voltage is limited by 1 LSB. Yes, for the previous question Prajwal also answered it. It's 9.99. yes, very good. Reference is 5. And its minimum output voltage is limited by value of 1 LSB. Yes. So can you tell me what is the resolution for this?
8.
8. Number of bits is 8. Okay. So how to do that? VFS is 4.97. So V reference is given. So from this we can directly write 1 LSB value. 1 LSB value is very close to 30 millivolt. 1 LSB is 30. So if you want to find number of bits, 1 LSB is VREF divided by 2 to the power of N. From this I can get N, and N is obtained as 7.4. So whenever you have EN in terms of decimal, always round off to the next value. Right. So that is your resolution. Resolution is expressed in terms of number of bits. Now, similarly, the next question asks this dynamic range. So let me see what is dynamic range first. So what is dynamic range? Generally, what is dynamic range?
Range of output.
Yeah, it is a range of output. So range of output in the sense, what is the largest possible output minus what is the smallest possible output. So this can be, dynamic range can be defined as the ratio of largest output signal, largest output signal over the smallest output signal. And the dynamic, so okay, let me write for a N-bit DAC. So example, if you consider an N-bit DAC, what is the maximum output an N-bit DAC can produce? Maximum output is equal to its full scale. So maximum is actually 2 to the power of N minus 1 into 1 LSB. Can I write in this way? For a 3-bit DAC, we have seen that maximum output is actually 7 by 8 into VREF, right? Then that way, can I write maximum output as maximum output is nothing but a full scale voltage, which can be expressed as 2 to the power of N minus 1 into 1 LSB. What is the minimum output?
0.
Minimum output is not 0. So for that, it is 1 LSB. So your output should change. The minimum change possible at the output is actually 1 LSB. Now, dynamic range is expressed as ratio of these two. So if we express in decibels, if we express in decibels, we will write this as 20 log 2 to the power of n minus 1 into LSB divided by LSB. Or this will be expressed as 20 log of 2 to the power of n minus 1. So this is the way we express dynamic range. Right. So if the number of bits, if the resolution is known, you can actually find the dynamic range of a DAC. Right. So it purely depends on the number of bits. Right. So with that, can you find the dynamic range for this DAC? Dynamic range for this stack. Any answers? Yes, I got one answer. Prajwal, 48.13. Okay. Yes, the dynamic range for this DAC is closely 48.13 decibels. Right. Okay, so I hope this is clear. Full scale voltage, dynamic range, resolution, 1 LSB calculation, all those things with respect to DAC is clear. So let me move to the next specification. So what is this? What we can see on this graph? This is a transfer carry of a DAC, right? So when I look at the transfer carry of a DAC, so always a y-axis is normalized to the reference voltage. So at any point, you can find the output voltage by just multiplying reference voltage to the y-axis values here, right? So in an ideal DAC, so now we will bring some non-ideal aspects of DAC into picture. So for an ideal DAC, what we always expect is, say for example, we can consider a 3-bit DAC. So I have taken example as a 3-bit DAC. So for an ideal 3-bit DAC, each adjacent output increment. So you see, this is the 000 is your first digital input word. For that, your output is actually 0. Then the next input digital word is 001. For that, what I expect is an output increment, and that output increment should be exactly 1/8. Right. Similarly, for each adjacent, for each change in the input, so I always expect the output increment, the adjacent output increment should be 1/8. In this the complete DAC output, what I always expect is this 1/8. And ideally, I can always expect this equal increment at the output. So ideally, any ideal DAC, I can expect equal increments, or the adjacent output increment will be exactly equal. And for a 3-bit DAC, it will be equal to 1/8 of your 1/8 will be the value. However, this is not true. Or when I look for a non-ideal DAC, so why I need to talk about a non-ideal DAC is we know that we do implement DACs and ADCs with components. We may use set of passive and active components, and even all those components have its own characteristics that may also deviate from the ideal behavior. So whenever we use non-ideal components to implement a DAC, this causes the non-idealities in those components may cause the analog increments. So I need analog increments at the output, but these non-idealities may cause analog increments to differ from their values, differ from their ideal values. That means what I always expect is for each output change, each input change, I expect 1/8 change at the output, but this 1/8 can actually deviate. It can be lesser or it can be more depending on the non-idealities present in the various components of a DAC. So now, if this varies, if your output increment is not incrementing equally, that actually that is introducing some error. Right. So now we need a performance measure to actually tackle this error, or actually to look at this non-ideality or this non-linearity. If you look at this graph, you can see the output of DAC is a straight line through origin. It is very linear. For each output input change, the output increment is equal, and you can see that the DAC response is linear. But if this increment is not equal, for example, from 000 to 001, if the DAC output is somewhere here, and for other change, if the DAC output is somewhere down, you cannot say that the output is linear. This becomes non-linear, right? So in such case, we have to have some performance measure to actually characterize this. And this non-linearity is usually measured by a parameter called differential non-linearity. Differential non-linearity, because this non-linearity is measured at each output increment. So each change, we are measuring this non-linearity. That is why we call this as differential non-linearity. So what is this differential non-linearity? It is basically the difference between the ideal and non-ideal values. So when I say ideal and non-ideal value, I can write differential non-linearity for an nth increment as, so we always have so actual increment height for each input change. What I expect is an increment at the output. So what is that increment? This one, this increment height. So there is an actual increment height of transition n. When I write transition n, it can be any bit change minus ideal increment height. Are you following this? So at the output, we always expect equal increments, but due to non-idealities, this increments can actually vary, or this increments can be something like non-linear. So if at all there is a non-linearity there, if at all there is a change, if the output increments are not equal, we try to measure that change, and we use a report in the form of a parameter called as differential non-linearity. And how to calculate this differential non-linearity is, you look at what is the actual increment height, and you subtract it from the ideal increment height. So that means, say for from 000 to 001, your actual height, so actual height I'll mark with green. So this is your actual height. Actual height is somewhat close to this value. So that minus your ideal increment. Ideal increment height is what I am marking in pink here. This is your ideal increment. So this quantity, or this much, is actually the error, which the error formed at this transition from 000 to 001. That is a error happened there, right? So whenever we write DNL, this DNL also, this DNL specification measures, or this gives an idea of how well a DAC can generate, uniform analog LSB multiples at the output. So this DNL specification measures how well a DAC can generate uniform analog LSB multiples at the output. So is this clear? What is this differential nonlinearity? So this differential nonlinearity is measured at each output increment, or this is measured for each digital input change. Now there is one more parameter, we call it as integral nonlinearity, where we accumulate all this differential nonlinearity together. Sum of all this differential nonlinearity will give you something called as integral nonlinearity. We'll come to that. Before that, we will look at this specific example. So look at this. Determine the DNL for a 3-bit non-ideal DAC whose transfer curve is given, given in this figure, and you are asked to calculate the DNL, the differential nonlinearity for this. So how to calculate differential nonlinearity? So we know only the formula. What is the formula? So the differential nonlinearity formula is DNL for any bit. So for example, n can be n can actually vary from your zero, your input can change from 0 to 1, 2, 3, all these change. So DNL can be written as actual increment height, actual increment minus ideal increment. Right. So can anyone of you tell me how to calculate DNL for this specific question? So that means I need to write DNL for each bit change. So first let me observe this. Is there any increment? Is there any increment for the digital word 000?
No,
there is no increment for digital word. So that should be separately noted. There is no increment for a digital word. Digital word 000. So no need to write DNL for that. Now, then we need to start DNL. So we need to write DNL starting from 1 to 7. So DNL should be reported for the change from 1 to 7. So let us write one by one. So what is DNL of 1? What is DNL of 1? So you can see from the graph that so these black dots represent the actual height. The actual height. And whatever you can see in the dotted line as a straight line is actually your, this is your ideal slope or the ideal height. So what is DNL of 1?
0.
So, yeah, DNL of 1 is 0 because what is actual height? Actual height is 1 LSB. Ideal height is also 1 LSB. So your DNL of 1 is equal to 0. Similarly, what is DNL of 2?
0.
Yeah, so this is same. This is 0. Let me see any other 0 value. Yeah, you can see one more. Okay, let us do one by one. So next is DNL of 3. So what is DNL of 3? So from 010 to 011. So this is 1, 2, 3. So DNL of 3 is supposed to be, the ideal height is this. What is this ideal height? It is given that what is the actual height? Actual height is given as 1.5 into ideal height. So how will I write this? 1.5 into ideal height is 1 LSB value minus, what is ideal height? It is 1 LSB value. So what is the DNL of 3.5 LSB? So we will always write, it is not always, we can write DNL in terms of LSB also. Right? Since the given data is in form of LSB, we will report DNL also in terms of LSB. So this is DNL of 3. Now, how to write DNL of 4? DNL of 4 is again from here to here. That means this. So this is the actual height. So what is actual height here? The actual height is 0.5 into ideal height. That is 0.5 LSB is the actual height. What is supposed to be the ideal height? It is 1 LSB. So what is the DNL value here? Is minus 0.5 LSB is the DNL value for 4. Similarly, you can write for DNL value of 5. What is DNL of 5? So this is 5. So 5, you can see only this much is the actual height. Actual height is only 0.25. So 0.25 of LSB minus 1 LSB value, which is equal to minus 0.75 LSB. That is DNL of 5. Now DNL of 6. DNL of 6, we have the actual height is this one. So how to write DNL of 6? Actual height is 1.75 LSB. That is actual height. And ideal height is LSB. So this is 0.75 LSB. DNL of 6. Right. So now the last one is DNL of 7. So what is DNL of 7? DNL of 7 is, this is the actual height and ideal height is also same. So DNL of 7 is 0. Right. So you got it. How did we calculate differential nonlinearity? That shows the nonlinearity for each input digital word change. Right. Any doubt? Any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay. Now the overall error for the DAC, which is defined by this DNL, we usually express in the form of a graph. It is only a pictorial representation where you, here you will write the digital input word, and here you express the DNL. This can be expressed in LSBs also. That is what we have the result now. Now this is zero. So you can represent this DNL for each. Zero one zero, zero one one, one zero zero, one zero one, one one zero, one one. Right. So what you can do is for zero zero, DNL of one is zero, so it is zero. DNL of two is also zero. It will continue like this. DNL of three is 0.5 LSB. If I mark this as 0.5. This is DNL of 3, which is 0.5 LSB. Then DNL of 4 is minus 0.5. So this is your minus 0.5. Then DNL of 5 is minus 0.75, so which will be further down. So you assume that this is minus 0.75. Then DNL of 6 is 0.75, which will go to top, and then finally it will come to 0. So this pictorial representation, or if you can see a variation in DNL on this graph, it is very clear that your DAC is a non-ideal DAC which have some non-linearities. Right. So for an ideal DAC, this will always be on the x-axis. So this is your DNL. Now let me and one more very important thing is generally. As a general rule, we always consider, let's come to this question in the next class. Okay, there are two more things to be noted. Generally, a DAC should have plus or minus half LSB as its DNL. Or the allowed DNL for a DAC is maximum plus or minus 0.5 LSB. Or we can define in a better way, for a DAC to be called n bit accurate, if a DAC is called n bit accurate, DNL max for any bit is plus or minus 0.5 LSB. The maximum allowed DNL is not more than 0.5. So let me ask this question. Say you have a DAC and you got your DAC is having a DNL of minus 1 LSB. What is the meaning of this? The DAC is having DNL of minus 1 LSB.
That means 001 can also be thought as the previous norm, 010.
Correct. That means DNL is always defined as actual increment minus ideal increment. Right. So if you get minus 1 LSB or minus LSB as DNL, that means actual increment is 0. Your actual increment is 0. So when you say actual increment is 0, what is the meaning? DAC is not producing an output in a monotonic fashion. So for each input change, there should be some change in the output. If that change is not happening, your DNL will be minus 1 LSB. In such case, whenever your DAC is having a DNL of minus 1 LSB, we say that DAC is actually a non-monotonic DAC. So DAC always should behave in a monotonic way. That means DAC should always exhibit the monotonicity nature. For each input change, there should be some change in the output. If that doesn't happen, your DNL, the DAC will show a DNL of minus 1 LSB. In that case, we call a DAC to be a non-monotonic DAC. Right. So I think we have only 5 minutes. So we will continue. Or I'll give you one question for you guys. You can calculate, and next day we will look at the answer. So the question is, you have a digital input for a 3-bit DAC starting from 000 and output voltage. This is not in terms of LSB, but this is given in terms of both. So for 00, output is 0. Here it is 0.625. It's 1.5625. 2.5. 3.125. 0.4375 and 4.375. These are the output voltages. Now the question is, determine DNL or determine the maximum DNL. DNL max for this 3-bit DAC. You can assume VREF as 5 volt. Right, so I'll tell you how to solve this. We know how to calculate DNL. So before calculating DNL, you can actually write two more columns here. One you can name as actual height. You can calculate actual height from each output. Then you can write ideal height here. So ideal height will be always equal to 1 LSB. Right, so that you can take it. And finally, you can, one last column, you can write DNL for each. So DNL is ideal actual increment minus ideal increment. So that can be calculated here, DNL. After that, you can plot and you can get the maximum DNL from that. Right. So this is also very important. For a DAC to be called n-bit accurate, DNL max, the allowed DNL max is only plus or minus 0.5 LSB. And a DNL of minus 1 LSB is otherwise called as non-monotonic DAC. So this question you can solve. Tomorrow we'll discuss the answer. So tomorrow I have scheduled one extra class, that is at 9 morning. Tomorrow we do not have AMS class, but tomorrow at 9 I'm keeping class to compensate what I missed on last Friday. Right. So if you have any doubts, we can discuss. Otherwise, we'll wind up. Okay. We'll continue next class.